Hi everyone, good morning. Yeah, thank you for watching this webinar. Okay, we shall start our presentation in a few minutes. For those who are using the laptop or desktop, you may use the Google Chrome to view this webinar for better streaming. Alternatively, you can also use your mobile phone and also your iPad to view this webinar as well. Okay, we shall start in a few minutes while waiting for others to get ready.
Grams of adhesive. 1 hour. 208 tons. 1 brand can make that math work. LOCTITE Universal Structural Bonders. So strong, versatile, and durable, there's no limit to what they can do.
Okay, so we shall start our webinar session now. Okay, good morning, everyone. Thank you for watching this webinar. Okay, my name is King Fong. I am the technical person for Henkel Malaysia, and this is my partner.
Hi, good morning, everyone. Ryan Tan, actually a sales engineer for Central Region.
Yeah.
So today we're going to cover our topic for limitless bonding with Loctite Universal Structural Bonders. So Kim Fong, I think our audience are actually looking forward for our agenda, right? So why not we tell more about our agenda for today's webinar?
Okay, sure. The agenda for today's webinar is first we will talk about the demands, market demands, and also the criteria customer will look for when they're choosing the structural adhesive. And then we'll move on to the introduction of our hybrid, Loctite hybrid adhesive to you all. We're talking about the benefit, the features, and also the things that hybrid can overcome for the end users.
Okay,
thirdly, we'll move on to the introduction of two Loctite hybrid products. Okay, where we'll be doing a small demonstration to the audience to see the special properties of our Loctite hybrid product.
Yep.
Okay, after that, we also move on to the Q&A sessions, where if any one of you have any questions or comments during our presentation, you can actually key in your comments in the text column, and then we will answer your questions during the webinar session as well. Okay, sure. That is about our agenda. Okay, so Ryan, before we move on to the introduction of structural adhesive, can I know what is your opinion on the typical properties of structural adhesive in the market?
Oh, yeah. Okay, so typical structural adhesive in the market is actually people who actually know about, it actually talk about strong and rigid properties, right? So it actually can actually fill in the high gap surface.
Yeah.
So, and then it also very high performance in on the metal surface. So yeah, this is really common properties of structural bonding in the market, right?
Okay,
right,
sure. Okay, Ryan, you are right about this. Okay, I think our audience will also know that some of typical structural adhesive, they have some limitation on them, such as they may have long fixture time, long curing time, right? And some of them may be having very strong smell to the users, where we would like to remove this limitation at all. Okay, so now I would like to move on to the next slide, where I will talk on the market demands on the current structural adhesive in the market.
Yep.
Okay. Currently, the end user will actually look for the reduction in weight of their end product.
Okay.
Yeah, they will choose the adhesive, especially the structural adhesive, rather than the mechanical fastening in their end product in order to reduce their weight. The weight of the end product. Okay, secondly, our end user will also look for the reduction in their cost, the manufacturing cost, and also manufacturing time to save their cost in the overall.
Yeah.
Okay. Thirdly, our end user will also look for high performance adhesive to make sure their end product is very reliable and durable in when they are delivered to the end customer. Okay. Fourthly, apart from the performance, our end user will also look for the health and safety compliant adhesive, where it doesn't cause very much harm to the user and also to the environment, which will eventually lead to the sustainability of the to the user environment as well. Okay, move on to the next slide. Okay, in the next slide, we will talk about the criteria then that the customer will concern on when they're choosing a structural adhesive. Okay, so the first criteria is that customer will look for the cost. They will consider the cost where they choose an adhesive. So they will look for the adhesive that will help them to save the cost. Be it in money in terms of times, in terms of labor costs, these are all the things that they will consider, right? Okay. And secondly, will be the product durability. So they will look for adhesive that is high strength and also high durability and also health and safety compliant to the customer as well. Okay. Thirdly, they will look for the speed. Speed here means that they will look for adhesive that is helping them to reduce the production cycle, to reduce the storage time and also reduce the downtime as well. So these are the three criteria that the end user will look for, will consider when they're choosing a structural adhesive. Okay.
I believe because our end user will actually more considering of these three criteria because it's relatively to their production line, right? So yeah, this is very, very important to our audience today.
Okay. Okay, moving on to the next slide. Okay, we will start to proceed to the introduction of our hybrid product. I think our audience is very might be interesting to know what is special about our hybrid product, right? So I think Ryan can expand some on the introduction of our hybrid.
Yeah, sure. So okay, so hybrid technology is actually a universal adhesive. So it actually consists with two components. Firstly, is cyanide acrylic, which in traditional market we call it CA or maybe super glue. So everyone know CA is actually have a fast curing on the surface. Right. So it actually very high performance in plastic surface. Right. So secondly, it consists with the structural bonding adhesive as well. So structural bonding, as I mentioned just now, is actually consists with strong and rigid bonders. Okay, it actually can fill in a high gap and also very, very high performance in on the metal surface.
This is about the introduction of our hybrid product. That's the properties of our product. Okay, so I think our audience will like to further understand more on what the benefit or the things that our hybrid product can bring to the customer, right?
So can
you move on to the next slide? Can you, Ryan, can you move on to, can you proceed to expand a little bit on it?
Okay, so hybrid product will actually helping a lot of operation process, right? So there are actually six highlights that I actually want to emphasize. So firstly, So hybrid product is actually helping our end user avoiding long curing time because of CA properties. It actually cure very fast and very performing in plastic substrate. Okay. Secondly, it actually avoiding the warranty claim thanks for the structural bonding properties. Strong and rigid. And it actually helping to generate a really reliability product. Okay, so the lead will actually avoid the defects, rework, and scrap because of a durability products for our addition, right? Okay, so for the fourth one, will actually overcome design limitation used in various substrate because hybrid product can actually addition for various kind of substrate. That's why we mentioned it in, it actually cater for universal addition. Right. So it actually very helpful to use one for multiple substrate. Okay. So lastly, it actually will help to overcome increase of inventory cost because as I mentioned just now, it can actually cater for multiple substrate. So it also helping to improve health and safety
And then, and also very, very easy to use.
Mm.
Yeah, you are right, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. So next slide, I think, thank you, Ryan. Thank you for your sharing on this. Now I will move on to the next slide where I will talk about the comparison of hybrid product and also the structural adhesive traditionally. Okay, as you can see in the current slide, there's a comparison table with different colors, right? So different colors represent different quality. So green color represent the good quality. The yellow color represent the intermediate quality, and also the red color represent the poor quality.
Yeah.
Okay, as you can see from the table, in terms of fixture time, the surface bonding versatility, and also the product reliability, actually hybrid perform comparable to the structural adhesive in the market right now. Okay, I would say it may not be the best performing adhesive in terms of all these three aspects, but when it comes to the health and safety concern, actually hybrid has a much improved performance in terms of health and safety concern, right?
Yep.
Yeah, so I would say hybrid product achieve a balance between the speed, between the strength, between the surface versatility, and also the health and safety concern. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's move on to the next slide. In the next slide, I will talk a little bit more on the health and safety concern of comparison between hybrid and also the structural adhesive in the market. Okay, for your information, actually, hybrid product actually smells just like super glue.
Mm,
yeah. As compared to the traditional MMA, I believe some of our audience will know if you are using MMA product, it's a very strong smell.
Okay.
Yeah, not comfortable to the users and also will cause harm to the environment.
Mm.
Okay, in terms of material content, hybrid product doesn't have a very much harmful product like isocyanide in the PU, polyurethane, or there's some materials which is very harmful to the environment. Yeah, so in all this, actually hybrid doesn't cause, in overall hybrid is actually is a user-friendly product in terms of health and safety and also environmental friendly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay. To the next slide, actually in the next slide, we will introduce, move on to the product line introduction, where we will introduce two hybrid product here. The first is 4090, okay, and second is 4080.
Yep.
So Ryan, can you talk a little bit more on the features of 4090?
Oh, sure. Okay, so for hybrid 4090, it's actually a fast and strong addition compared to normal epoxy, right?
Yeah.
So like I said just now, hybrid actually can go for versatile substrate. So for example, we can actually go for metal, rubber, or maybe plastic, right?
Yeah.
So speed and strength, because of the CA and structural bonding properties.
Yeah.
And it also, like, they have the moisture and temperature resistant for our hybrid adhesive. So what about the hybrid 4080?
Okay, about 4080 is actually is special it can cater for the impact resistant application.
Mm.
This is because it is formulated with toughened grade. So it is suitable for those applications which require impact resistant or like shock resistant application. Okay. Similar to 4090, actually 4080 is also a high chemical and temperature resistant.
I see.
Yeah.
I see.
But the most important thing is 4080 has the improve health and safety concern, health and safety formulation where it doesn't have very strong smell as compared to the traditional MMA. This is very important to the user and also environment as well, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so Ryan, why don't we do a little demonstration on showing the fast and strong feature of hybrid product as compared to the normal epoxy to the audience?
Yeah, sure. I think our audience will really looking forward to see our demonstration, because just stand here saying about the product, I think it's not really convincing.
Yeah.
So we actually prepared some tools here to do the demonstration to show our audience.
Mm, yeah.
So to let our audience to have a really eye seeing better result each kind of adhesive.
Okay.
Right? Okay, so shall we start now?
Okay, let me explain on what we're going to do right now.
Right.
Yeah, actually we have a metal lab shear here. So what we're going to do is we have a 1490 product here, and also we have a normal epoxy product
yes.
here. Okay. We are going to do a assembly using both product on different metal lab shear, and then we will stand the after bonding. We will let it to stand for 5 minutes
yep.
again, and then we will test it with take the strength with using the weight after 5 minutes.
Yeah,
okay. So okay, shall we let's start
yeah.
now?
Yes. I just concern our audience mm-hmm. will actually have a question.
Yeah.
What we should actually have a caution concern before doing the assemble job.
Oh, okay, of course there is some concern when we want to do some when we're dealing with chemicals
yeah.
and adhesive, right?
Mm,
so
yeah.
when we have to deal with adhesive or chemicals, we need to wearing the PPE, proper PPE like goggles, like glove, and proper protective cloth as
yeah.
well. Okay, so and also for the bonding, when we do the assembly. Before we do the bonding, we need to make sure our surface, bonding surface is clean.
I see.
Okay. So what we're going to do is we'll be using the cleaner
mm-hmm.
to do the cleaning before we actually do the assembly. Okay. So
we'll be using the... what if the our end user are not doing the cleaning job?
Okay.
Is there any effect?
Of course, there is any effect if we didn't do the cleaning process, when we do the bonding, it will actually eventually affect the bonding performance of the adhesive because of the presence of contaminants on the surface, on the bonding surface.
I see.
Yeah. So now we have done cleaning the metal lab shear.
Yep.
Now we're going to install this, assemble this cartridge on the manual applicator here. Okay. So after assemble, before we attach the nozzle onto the cartridge, we need to make sure the material flow, two-part material flow of the cartridge is smooth and
yeah.
no any bubbles. So what we do is we just push a little bit out.
Yeah, looks
okay.
like it's
to make sure it flow the two parts is flowing out.
Yep.
And no bubbles.
Yep.
Okay. So after make sure two part is flowing out smoothly, now we attach the nozzle and we need to pushing some amount out from after attaching the nozzle to make sure the materials are mixing well. Okay. So this is similar to for epoxy. Okay. After doing the step, now we are ready to bond this metal lab shear together. Okay. So we apply it on the bonding surface. Okay. Then we assemble it.
And then we clip
yeah.
in the metal paper.
Mm. Then we stand for
five minutes
before
so,
we do the testing. So we may start the clock, like the timer.
The timer right now.
Yeah, right now, yeah. Okay.
Starting right now.
Okay, so Ryan, while we're waiting for 5 minutes, I think
yeah.
We can talk a little bit more on the key values or benefit that each product, each hybrid product can bring to the audience, right? So
yeah.
can you expand on the 1490 product?
Yeah, so allow me to explain the benefits.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so there are five benefits by using the hybrid product to the operation, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the first one I wanted to say is reliability.
Mm-hmm.
So this one is actually improving the product quality because of the strong and rigid bonding properties,
mm-hmm.
right? So it actually lower the failure rate for the production process,
yeah, course,
right?
Yeah.
So the secondly will be health and safe, right?
Mm.
So like Kenpong mentioned just now,
yeah.
less audio, and even though just now when I'm pushing the adhesive out, I can actually smell the epoxy is actually really stronger than hybrid.
Yeah.
So it actually less hazard to end user as well.
Yep.
So we'll actually link to the environmental friendly for using our hybrid product.
Yep.
Okay. So thirdly, we'll actually talk about the simplify and reduce complexity. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So this one is actually very simplified to the storage, especially for those kind of operators.
Mm-hmm.
They need to push to bonding for
yeah.
various type of substrate, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
So by using the
hybrid
product,
mm-hmm.
you can actually purchase one cartridge or few cartridge of hybrid product, you know, inventory. So this one is actually very easy for storage, and it's also very easy for supplier handling the cartridge for, for the end user, right?
Yeah.
So and also it's very easy to use.
Yeah.
As you can see just now, we apply into applicator and I can actually push up just like that, simple as that.
Yeah.
All right. So what is actually speed? Thanks for the CA properties. Actually increasing the speed and also related to the productivity to the operators. Right. So last but not least, versatile. So it actually improving new production development, especially for the R&D designer.
Correct.
So I believe they were actually happy to use this for a lot of trials for the new production development.
Yeah.
So this one is actually a benefit for the 4090 hybrid.
Yeah. So this sounds very attractive to the end users, right, with these properties. Okay, now on the next slide, I will talk on the benefit of the 4080 product. Okay, so the first benefit of 4080 is that it is reliable. It is, it can, because due to its high strength and high, it will produce a high quality product and reduce the failure rate. Also thanks to its structural adhesive properties. Okay, secondly, the substrate versatility is also similar to 4090, where you can bond to or cater for many kind of substrate application, from metal to rubber, same as 4090. So it is considered as a good option for the designers or developer to actually develop their product. Okay,
yeah,
using different substrate. So it's a designer-friendly product. Okay. So thirdly, in terms of health and safety concern, similarly, actually, 4090 doesn't have a very, and 4080 doesn't have a very strong smell as compared to the traditional MMA. So it actually help to improve the health and safety concern of the end user and also to the environment. Okay, and last but not least is the simplicity. Similar to 4090, due to its substrate versatility, it can bond to many substrate. Okay, actually, the end user can only use one cartridge to cater for many applications.
Yes, that's a really nice of our hybrid product.
Imagine that you just need one cartridge to cater for many applications, then you just need to adhere to one inventory and one supplier only.
Yes.
So this is very save a lot of process and also a lot of time to the company as well.
And also will very safe for the inventory cost.
So if you have any if you have interest or like to try this product on your part on your new project, you can actually drop us a message by clicking on our speaker bio. There's an email a link for us to you can actually drop the email to us, and we shall attend to your inquiry after this. So this is the key benefit of each product of 4090 and 4080.
Looks like the time has passed.
So
we shall actually test our
the demonstration just now. Okay.
So what we shall do is we will using the free weight plate.
Free weight. So one piece will equivalent to 1.25 kg weight.
This is not the fake one. It's actually we steal from gym.
Joking. We prepare for ourselves. This is a real weight.
It's a real weight.
1.25 kg.
Yeah.
So what I'm going to do is I will cram this Wonder Lab shirt using this weight. So I will start test with 1.25 kg first.
Okay,
so we can start the
start testing. Like
it can stand, withstand the weight, right? 1.25. How about we try on 2.5 kg?
Let's see the result.
Are
we adding on the weight?
So this is actually 2.5 kg weight. It can actually stand the weight, the strength in 5 minutes. Okay, so this shows the fast and strong properties of 4090 product.
So why not we try the epoxy?
This is a normal epoxy. So if we start with 1.25 kg. Weight.
Same thing.
The paper. We cram it and then iron piece.
And I will try to test it up like this. You can see it's actually slowly slipping away.
Okay, finally.
Breaks the bond.
So this obviously we can see here actually this is very much different between the fast and strong properties of OD90 and also the normal epoxy. Yep. So these fast and strong properties eventually will bring the benefit to you all is by reducing the production cycle time, reducing the storage time and or WIP time as well. Yeah. So okay, that will be all about our demonstration and also our technology sharing today.
Yeah.
So now we shall move on to the Q&A session.
Yes.
Okay. So
Oh yeah, we received from some question from the audience, right?
I
think one of our audience are actually concerned about the storage condition. So our hybrid product can actually store in the normal fridge.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually the temperature resistant is actually from 2 up until 25 degrees Celsius.
Storage condition.
Yeah.
Storage temperature is between 2 to 21.
Yeah, so you can actually store in the fridge, so it won't actually destroy the
properties. Maintain the shelf life.
Yes. And secondly, we also have the shelf life of hybrid product too, right? So it actually have 12 months, I would say 1 year of shelf life for hybrid product, right? So yeah, this is the
question
that I actually received.
Okay.
So what about Ken Fong?
Oh yeah, I also actually received 2 questions from the audience. Okay, the first is the audience is asking, can it be used in a GRE pipe? So my comment is actually hybrid can cater for any types of substrate, many types of substrate, including the metal to plastic or to rubber. So
yeah.
Depending on the application, but in terms of substrate wise, the hybrid product actually can cater for this application. But we also need to consider some other factor like the bond gap. The bonding gap, the bonding surface, the fixture time requirement, all this together. So I would say substrate wise, it can cater for this application, the GRE pipe, but we need to consider other things as well, like the things I mentioned just now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the second question is, what is the mixing ratio of the hybrid? Okay, as we can see visually, the cartridge itself, actually 4090 and 4080 is 1-to-1 mixing ratio cartridge. So because of the size of the both cartridge, they are equally the same. So it means that it is a 1-to-1 mixing ratio. So, but don't worry, because our cartridge is already back for the proper mixing ratio. So what we need to do is we just push out and then it will mix the amount precisely already.
Mm-hmm.
So okay, that will be the question. Okay, I think we received some other questions. Okay, inbound is sweating wet condition. Okay, so the next question is from the audience is, can it be bonded in the sweating or wet condition?
Yeah.
Okay, I think not only apply to the 4090 or the hybrid product, to any adhesive. We need to make sure the surface, bonding surface, is clean and dry before we do the bonding. Why? It's because if you imagine there's a water component on your surface, if you apply the adhesive on it, actually your adhesive doesn't really bond to the surface. It may be bond to the water component.
Mm-hmm.
So this eventually will not be a very good assembly. So in wet condition, I would advise that make sure the surface is dry first.
Yeah.
It's dry first before we do the SMB.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, okay. Can we get products from any hardware stores? Okay. Another question is that whether we can get this product from any hardware stores, is actually not possible to get from hardware store currently.
Yeah. Yeah. Because this product is relatively new in the market right now, and I also we also really encouraging our end user to direct purchase the hybrid product from our distributor. So our authorized distributor. So if you have any question about authorized distributor, you can always look for us. So we can try to help you to sort out the problem, right?
Okay. So I think we have any question. Okay, what is the performance? Okay. There's another question is that what is the performance of hybrid product in a high temperature moisture environment? Okay, in term for this condition, mm-hmm. is high temperature and moisture environment. As for hybrid product, the temperature resistance of hybrid product is actually can be up to 150 degrees Celsius.
Mm-hmm.
So so for those applications within below 150 degrees Celsius, it can cater for this application. And also moisture environment, actually our hybrid product is resistant to moisture environment as well.
Yep.
Because of its structural properties.
Yes. Yes.
We have structural component inside this hybrid product. So there's no, hybrid product can cater for moisture environment and temperature environment up to 150 degrees Celsius.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, okay. So we have already received this question. I think there's one more question from the audience.
Yep.
Right. Okay. Just wait for it. Okay, I think we have another question. Is 5 minutes will have a high bonding in short time, but I have to wait until how long to have an optimal adhesion? The answer is we advise to have a 24 hours curing time to
yeah.
reach the 100% adhesion.
Yeah.
Yeah, this applies to not only the hybrid products,
also to various kind of adhesive.
LOCTITE hybrid products, we also advise to have a 24 hours curing time to make sure it's really performing.
Yeah.
But 5 minutes time, you ensure the fixture strength
yeah.
is already there
yeah.
that the end user could actually proceed to the next process. They don't have to wait for long time like epoxy.
You have to wait like
30 minutes, 1 hour, which is longer than the hybrid product.
Yes.
So in this term, 5 minutes can help the user to save a lot of time, production time.
Especially for them to actually further examples other parts, right?
Yeah, yeah, okay. Okay, can we use heat? Another question is, can we use heat to accelerate the curing? The answer is yes, because of its structural properties.
Mm-hmm.
Structural properties. We can use the heat to accelerate the curing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think, is there any
further question?
Yep. Okay. That will be it for our Q&A session.
Yeah. So maybe we will wrap up this webinar section.
Today. I think it's a wrap for our webinar session today.
Yep.
If you have any further question, actually you can drop us an email or
mm-hmm.
to reach to our sales representative on each region to have the answer. Or if you have any you would like to raise a sample, or you would like to give a try to your new project using our hybrid product.
Yes.
You are actually free to come to us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
thank you.
Thank you for today. So I hope you guys have a nice day.
Yeah.
So
we'll see you very soon again.
Yes. Don't feel hesitate to call us. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye.